Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 6 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now, in the previous video, I explained how channels work within the sequencer, and I'm going to be able to show you a little bit of how that works today, because we're going to be doing our first multi-channel edit. And this is going to require that we import 2 movie files into our sequencer, and this will give me the opportunity to show you how to deal with one of the most common problems that we have when importing separate movie files, and that is dealing with differing resolutions. Now, in today's video, I'm not going to talk about dealing with differing frame rates, because you guys really should be converting all of your videos to the same frame rate, because it's really difficult to actually deal with different frame rates in the sequencer. You can, but it's better just to convert them using a transcoder outside of the program and then import them in and just deal with resolution issues and the rest of the editing. So let's get started, and let's go down to the Add menu, and we're going to select Movie, and the first movie we're going to select is Big Buck Bunny. And let's go back down to the Add menu again, select Movie again, and Tears of Steel will be our second movie. Now, as usual, I always tell you guys, whenever you import your movies into your sequencer, always check that each movie's audio and video strips are matching, because if they are not matching, that means that the frame rate is set wrong, and it is, because both of these movies are actually 24 frames per second. Now, here is what I really wanted to talk about today, and that is we have 2 different video strips, and unfortunately, if you look at each strip's original dimension, you'll see that they have differing resolutions. Now, this means we have to make a choice. What do we want to set our resolution to in our render settings? Because one of these videos is going to be set to the wrong resolution. Well, I usually just select the bigger resolution, and then I make an adjustment to the other videos that are imported to make them the correct aspect ratio and to center them and just place them generally correctly. So let's set it to the bigger resolution, which is actually 1280 by 720, the Big Buck Bunny strips resolution. So we'll click on that with our right mouse button, and we will click Strip and select the set render size. And now it has 1280 by 720 in our render settings, and you can see it changed this window. Now, let's skip ahead to see what we actually have. And now, this is where we can demonstrate what I talked about in the previous video, which is how our channels work. Now, you can see that Tears of Steel is actually on channel 3, and the video for the Big Buck Bunny movie is actually on channel 1. So that means that the preview window is actually going to prefer to see channel 3, which is Tears of Steel. But what's wrong with this? This guy's face looks like it's a little bit long, and that is because this is the video that does not have the correct dimensions for the resolution. So we have to make an adjustment to this video strip so that it will look better. So let's do that by going over to, by selecting the video strip and going over to the properties. And what we're going to do is they have an option right here called Image Offset. It's a checkbox. So you can just put a checkbox there, and now it brought it to the correct resolution. And we can now click our left mouse button on the Y coordinates, because below it we have the XY coordinates to move it. And so left click on the Y coordinate and pull to the right, and this will actually help us to center it, pull to the left to pull it down, and it will give us bars on the top and the bottom, but it is the correct aspect ratio. Now, there's one other thing you can do, and that's if you don't want to have one video be full framed and the other one have bars, you can just fix this one by zooming it, and that will require that we actually use the transform strip. So the way that we do that is we click on our video that we want to adjust with the right mouse button, and we go down to Add, and we select Effect Strip. And from Effect Strip, we select Transform. Now, it's important that whenever you're doing a transform on a video or an image strip, you always take the original one, right-click on it, and hide it. And you want to go down to the Strip menu and select Mute Strips. Or you can hit the H button after selecting it. And this is just something you want to do. You'll see in the future why we do it, but always mute your strips after you have created a transform layer from them. So now we can go up and select our transform layer, and our transform layer actually has a full copy of this video in it. So even we've muted this one down here, and you wouldn't be able to see it, but it doesn't matter because we have a copy in the transform layer. So now we can go over to our properties for the transform, and we can see that we have a bunch of different options. We can set a uniform scale for scaling or zooming, and we can drag by clicking with our left mouse button, left or right, and we can shrink this or grow it. So let's zoom it till it fills the full frame, and there you go. Now we have two videos that are going to go to the full frame size. And just to show you that they will, I'm going to actually cut so that we can see below them. And you can see these are now both full frame. Okay, let's go to our next video.